Why, hello there, everybody. How are you doing today? It's me, again and again. I am here to encourage you. I'm here to embolden you. I'm here to empower you. I'm here to motivate you. I'm here to inform you. I'm here to educate you. I'm here to build. You heard me right. I'm here to build you up. I'm here to lift you up. I'm here to bring and give you peace. I'm here to bring and give you hope. Because I'm here to bring, give, and tell you the truth. Okay. It seems like that one day everybody believes it changes here. And then the next day, everybody's convinced that nothing's going to change. Now, I don't know if that's because that's what's really going on, or if that's what the people that don't want anything to change want everyone to believe. You see, the news media as it stands right now is, it has to go. They've been lying to you, Miwi. They have been deceiving you, Miwi. They have been programming you, Miwi. They have been trying to manipulate and control you, Miwi. And they've got to go. The government is as corrupt as it's ever been. And these people are bold. These people are doing everything they can to prevent accountability from coming in. And again, these are people who for decades have been telling us, and who we believe are good guys, God-fearing conservatives. And yet we're hearing them laugh and talk about world war. They're fakes, they're frauds. They're being outed. But here's the good news, folks. 14 days. 14 days, or 13 days in a wake-up. How about that? And that's why you're seeing more and more of this stuff come up. That's why you're seeing stuff like the what happened the other day with the young man. The special needs man that was kidnapped and everything. That's why, and tortured. He was tortured. It was a hate crime. That's the reason why mainstream media put that out there. They're trying to instigate. Again, there is no doubt it was a hate crime. You know it. I know it. We all know it. I'll put up with a little sun. You know it, I know it, we all know it. It was a hate crime. There's no other way to put it. But folks, stop screaming at the TV because they don't hear you. That's what they want you to do. They want you to get frustrated. It's what they want you to do. Turn them off. You turn them off, you turn off their funding source. They are nothing without you, me, we watching them. Turn them off. Turn them off. You're not going to. There are no good guys. Whoa, I really like this guy. I really like this guy. Folks, they are there. It's a business. It is a business. These people could care less about truth. They're in it for money, for prestige, for fame. Bottom line, they're attention whores. They're prostitutes. Google prostitute and look at the second definition of prostitute. Everybody just wants to go with a woman that sells her body. Look at the second definition of a prostitute. That's the real definition of a prostitute. Google it. You Google it. I'll tell you what. I'll include it in the description. I ain't going to tell you what it is. It's going to surprise the snot out of you. And you're going to find out that, oh, guess what? There has not been a point in anyone's life, or should I say the majority of us, that at some point in time, you, me, we have not prostituted ourselves. And again, we're not talking about sex. Read the second definition. It's in the description. It's there or there or there or wherever the heck the description is in this video. That's the reality. There are no good guys. There are no, oh, well, he's a nice person. I said it yesterday. These people are actors. All they care about is themselves, their own families. And there's nothing wrong with wanting the best for your family. But there's something wrong when you put the needs of others, when you put your needs above the needs of others. That's totally unscriptural. And that's all that they're doing. And these people that are still pitting one group against another. Okay, I'm going to say something. It's going to get some of you all mad, but it's the truth. Okay? There's race baiters on both sides. One more time. There's race baiters on both sides. If all you are doing is talking about one race, you're a race baiter. Because that's all the left talks about, is one race. How one race is a victim. Well, if all you're talking about is how one race needs to be... the exact opposite. You're still doing the same thing. You're just using different verbiage. You're a race baiter. Go ahead. You keep operating by man's standards. See, some of you all still have not caught on yet. You think that nothing's going to change. You're about to get your feelings hurt. You're about to get shocked. 14 days. You all are about to get shocked. There's real change coming, folks. Just because the race baiters, see, the mouthpieces, the media still has power because they're still in place. God doesn't leave a void, though. God cannot remove these things without having a replacement because there is a purpose for them. There is a need for them. But all this sensationalism stuff, especially when you're doing all this sensationalism stuff in the name as a Christian, I don't care. I don't care who your mama was. I don't care who your daddy was. I don't care what church you went to. You can call somebody brother, sister, whatever. The truth does not need to be hipped up. The truth does not need to be cooled up. The truth does not need to be millennialed up. It doesn't need a little soul to it. The truth is the standard that the lie cannot meet, because it is the truth that is the standard that the lie that defines the lie. Doesn't matter who says the truth. And the truth is, whoever tells the truth, whoever lives the truth, is doing it right. There isn't one race, one sexual orientation that is above the other, that has it better off. So you know what? You just keep doing, and you know who you are. You know who you are. We're tired of it. I'm telling you what's going to happen. One day, my brother, you're going to wake up and you're going to say, where did everybody go? Because we're tired of hearing all of this division, divisive stuff. All of this sensationalism. We're tired of it. Stop it. Just tell the truth. I could really care less what race, what religion, what creed, what country these people came from that did this to that man. And irregardless of whether the man was white, black, red, brown, purple, yellow, or plaid. Irregardless of whether or not the man was special needs or just as normal as you and me. Doesn't matter. A crime was committed. The law must be applied. And the simple fact that we're having a problem with that, the simple fact that you just won't say that, tells me you don't want a solution. You just want to keep propagating a problem. You just want to keep creating, you just want to keep creating paradoxical situations to catch 22s, which tells me that you are the problem and you will have no part. You better change. Go ahead. Keep preaching division. And again, both sides do it. Both sides do it, both the right and the left, Republicans and Democrats, liberals and conservatives. They both preach the same thing. They just use different verbiage. But it's both. There's nothing unifying about it. Nothing. And some of you all are still to this day. Some of you all are still to this day. I'm not going to show that video, but we'll just talk about it for the next 5 days. Mm-hmm. Go look at the second definition of prostitute down in the description or over there in the description. You're going to get your feelings hurt. You're going to get your feelings hurt. Stop it. But that's wrong. Yeah, that is wrong. But you're not in a position. You're not making it any more right. You're not putting out a solution. All you're doing is stirring up discourse, anger, division. That's all you're doing. That's it. You're taking their bait. Don't take the bait. Don't take the bait. Okay, so what do? I said it yes the other day. 2 Chronicles 7:14. If my people, which are called by my name, shall humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then will I hear from heaven and will forgive their sin and will heal their land. Stop playing by man's rules. You know your creator? If you know your creator, then you know you don't have to operate. You do not have to operate by man's rules. In fact, if you know your creator, you know you are not supposed to operate by man's rules because you operate by his rules. Those who keep saying that, oh, well, this is just the way that it's always been done. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Nothing's ever going to change because Because this is the way that it's always been done. You want to bet? Want to bet? I wonder who else thought that. Let's see. I wonder if the people back in Noah's Ark times, back when Noah was building the ark, if they said, you know what? This is just the way it's always been. It's never going to change. Mm-hmm. Oh, by the way, it had never rained. Ever. Ever. They didn't even know what rain was. Uh-huh. They had a rude awakening as soon as that first drop of rain hit them on the forehead. Now, didn't it? Mm-hmm. Oh, it ain't always going to be like it always is. Like it's always been. Tell you who else. Let's see. Oh, Sodom and Gomorrah. Mm-hmm. Abraham shows up. They take Lot. This is always the way it's been. Mm-hmm. Okay. Always been the way it's been. All of a sudden, God says, get out. Leave. Leave. I'm going to destroy the place. I'm quite sure that the people in those two cities, because it's two cities, it wasn't one, it was two cities, Sodom and Gomorrah, they felt differently as soon as that first fire and brimstone, first wave of fire and brimstone came crumbling down on them. But it's always been this way, right? Right? Right. You know, I bet you all of Egypt said, hey, we've always had these Israelites as slaves. We're not letting them go. They're not going anywhere. It's always been this way. Mm-hmm. Took 10 plagues, killing the firstborn. And then, hey, they had to take out Pharaoh himself. You know what? Change showed up real quick, didn't it? Well, look at that. It ain't always going to be what it's always been. You know what? I'm sure when Goliath walked out there on that field, and he walked out 40 times. Actually, it was 80 times. He walked out for 40 days, twice a day. He walked out in the morning and in the evening, 40 days in a row. You know, and I'm quite sure he had never met defeat, because he was still standing there. And I'm quite sure the Philistine army said, oh, they're going to back down, they're going to surrender, we won't even have to fight. And even if they do send out somebody to fight, Goliath's going to win because, hey, he's always won. It's always been this way. It'll never be something else. Mm-hmm. Until little David let loose that sling. Then they ran. Because David let loose the sling, knocked Goliath flat on his face, then ran up to Goliath, used Goliath's own sword and cut his head off, and then raised it up. And then all of a sudden the Philistines said, you know what, hey, it ain't always going to be like it's always been. So you know what? You all are about to find out. It ain't always going to be like it's always been. Stop. Stop acting like nothing's going to change. Stop acting like nothing has changed. Start operating. Start operating in your upgrade. Start operating in truth. If my people, which are called by my name, shall humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then will I hear from heaven and will forgive their sin and will heal their land. Stop spreading discourse. Start spreading unity. Stop caring. Okay, it's real simple. Are you serving the gift or are you serving the gifter? Are you serving the blessing or are you serving the blesser? Are you giving orders or are you receiving orders? If you're giving orders, then that means you believe you in charge. A servant receives orders and does his master's bidding. So again, do you serve the blessing or do you serve the blesser? You're the only one that can answer that question. Get right. Stop doing it man's way. We're operating underneath a new standard. Change is here, my friends. Change is here. Just saying.